Imagine you could travel back in time, to a time long before demonetization. Back across 13 years. As you travel, you would see huge changes in the quality of YouTube. Even the layout of the site itself would improve as constraints are pushed out by user-friendliness. Now you've reached a remarkable period in YouTube's history, known as the 2000s. It is a very different world. Google Plus does not yet exist, and censorship is only half as common. There are no corporations, only individuals making content for fun. This is a world ruled by toy videos. Okay, so I normally don't make videos about stuff going on YouTube, since there's already plenty of other YouTubers who've been doing it for years and probably know what they're talking about more than me in that area. If you've been on this site for as long as me and have kept up on what's going on, you're probably aware of all the problematic changes YouTube has gone through over the years. There's really nothing I could say about the selective enforcement of the YouTube guidelines, false copyright claims, and the ugly layout that hasn't already been said before. However, there's one thing about the current and former state of videos on YouTube that I haven't seen anyone talk about, even though it really means a lot to me. The history of toy videos. It seems like whenever commentary channels talk about toy videos today, they rant about how YouTube's algorithm is now programmed to heavily promote low-effort recordings of toddlers playing around with corporate-sponsored toys, being used to farm views and ad revenue from children who don't know how to use Adblock or turn off the default autoplay feature. In short, toy videos have become a symbol of low-effort clickbait, parents exploiting their kids for ad revenue, and the people in charge of YouTube trying to force a family-friendly image on their site with obvious favoritism and special treatment for some people and not others. Now, I'm just as annoyed by this whole thing as anyone else, but what I find particularly sad is that people seem to have forgotten that toy videos weren't always like this. Every YouTuber who talks about this issue never mentions what toy videos used to represent. Back in the days when people just made videos on YouTube for fun, when kids and teenagers with no budget were making enjoyably campy amateur projects with what little they had, there was a whole genre of videos where toys were the stars, where instead of adults filming kids goofing around with toys in order to sell a product, kids themselves were the ones behind the camera, creating their own stories and acting them out with stop motion, or by moving the toys around in front of the camera while trying to keep their hands out of view. Everyone who reminisces about the old YouTube videos that first attracted them to the site has their own idea of what those classic videos are, the ones that defined the early days of the site. For some, it's the comedy sketches, for some, it's the animations, for some, it's the YouTube poops, music video tributes, and other fan-made re-edits of movies and TV shows, and for me, it was toy videos. Contrary to what you might think, these weren't the kinds of videos where if you saw one, you'd seen them all. Different YouTubers who specialized in toy videos each had their own style. Some of them filmed in their backyards, some on tabletops, some in just random areas of their parents' houses. Some of them made arbitrary short skits, some made long, planned-out movies and series. Some toy videos were simple and minimalistic, others got really creative with computer-generated effects. People even experimented with different genres. Most were just meant to give you a good laugh, but every now and then, someone would go above and beyond and try to make a toy video that was legitimately serious and dramatic. A mystery, an exciting adventure, a tragedy. You'd go in thinking toy videos weren't supposed to make you feel things, and yet some people actually went and did it, and you'd be amazed how well some of these people pulled it off. Much like every other kind of video on YouTube at the time, people who made toy videos were constantly experimenting with new techniques, taking inspiration from each other, and trying to make their videos stand out from the rest of the community. All this innovation and out-of-the-box thinking led to a wide range of weird and fascinating toy videos. Stop-motion Lego videos were especially popular, with one of my favorites from back then being An Average Death Star Day by E-Animation, a Star Wars fan film with the iconic characters acting like bumbling fools getting into comical situations. I always liked the minimalist style. Low resolution, no flashy effects, all the enjoyment came from the jokes and the energy of the characters' movements. The LEGO videos of Forest Fire 101 still make me laugh to this day, with their inventive scenarios and great sense of comedic timing. My absolute favorites, though, were Demon Shrieker and Raptor Boy 101, who once again had a minimalistic style, but also gave you a sense of their personality and interests through their videos. Demon Shrieker's Night of the LEGO Dead really puts a smile on my face with the creative ways he utilizes blood and gore with clay and dismembered LEGO body parts. As you can imagine, there were lots of dinosaur toy videos that I was a huge fan of. There was actually a huge trend amongst the dinosaur video community of making Walking with Dinosaurs-inspired documentary series, with people filming their dinosaur toys out in the backyard and pretending it was a prehistoric jungle while narrating what was going on. Even though many of these were very similar, I still enjoyed seeing new people doing their own take on the genre. Some other dinosaur toy videos that influenced my early works were Escape of the Dinosaurs by Luxor, a simple short with no dialogue where a bunch of toy dinosaurs led by a raptor break free from their toy box and escape to freedom in the wild. Dinosaur Movie by Brandon Sachs, which had army action figures fighting dinosaurs while on a rescue mission, featuring hilarious voice acting and some actually decent-looking gunfire and explosion effects. And Skull Island by Red Dalek 555, a King Kong fan film with surprisingly good characters and dramatic moments. But by far the best of these old toy videos was the movie Figuremation, a feature-length movie where a Princess Leia toy, a Ken doll, and a Beanie Baby go on an epic adventure, encountering army figures, Pokemons, Godzillas, and everything in between.
What is it, General?
Mr. President,
what?
We are ready to go to the natives and conquerors and destroy them!
Yes!
Can I go now?
Yes, you may.
Okay, here we go.
Wait, I just want to say thanks for asking me. No one's ever been that considerate to ask me before. You are a very sweet man. No, I want a hug! I want a hug!
I'm completely serious when I say it's one of the funniest, most inspiring things I've ever seen in my life. It really shows the extent to which a movie made with toys in a basement can go. The real allure of these videos to me as a kid was that, just like with other genres of YouTube content, they were made by regular people. Kids filling their spare time with making movies using the only resources available to them. It all just looked so easy, so tangible. It really gave you a strong urge to go and make your own videos. Even if all you had was your parents' video camera and some toys, you could turn that into something entertaining. Sure, not all toy videos were good, and even the ones with effort put into them that I've just mentioned would probably still be viewed by most people as stupid and corny, but for some people, these videos had a certain appeal. Their campiness and unconventional style was just part of the charm. It attracted a considerable audience, and I, of course, was part of that audience. It was, as many of you know, how I first got into making videos for YouTube. It got me noticed by other people who were into that same hobby and allowed us to talk to and work off of each other. It wasn't just the fun of making and watching videos, it was being part of a community of people with this commonality. Sadly, it looks as though these kinds of videos won't be around for much longer. What with YouTube now manipulating the algorithm to mark every video that has anything to do with toys as for kids only, and censoring it in the algorithm to make sure few people will ever see it again. And while some may celebrate that the commercialized toy videos will be given this treatment, I find it very depressing that these videos will probably be lumped in with them. Like I said, these videos greatly inspired me as a little kid when I was just learning about filmmaking. I didn't have access to many resources to make movies one would consider high art, but seeing people from my age group making do with what they had showed me that I could make videos of my own and just have fun doing it. Even though most of these people from the old days have long since abandoned their channels, it is nice to see there are some newcomers following in their footsteps, and I hope this unique subculture continues to persist and be noticed, to not get buried by or lumped in with these corporate-sponsored toy videos that have become a target of ridicule. I've included a playlist link in the description to some of these videos, and if there's any others you think deserve more recognition, please let everyone know in the comment section. I would also recommend downloading them while you still can, just in case YouTube decides to take them down from the internet entirely. My hope is that this niche of YouTube content won't be lost or forgotten, and will continue to inspire and entertain the filmmakers of the future.